We begin tonight in Israel, where authorities today arrested six men they believe are responsible for the revenge murder of a Palestinian teenager. The 16-year-old was beaten and burned alive, an incident apparently sparked by the kidnapping and murder of three Israeli teenagers. The arrests were one of several important developments in Israel today. For more, we are once again joined via Skype in Jerusalem by Josef Federman of the Associated Press. Joe, thanks again for joining us. What do we know about the arrests today?
Well, Israeli authorities have just announced that they arrested several suspects. They haven't given the official number, but officials are saying they have six people in custody. The arrest took place this morning, and everybody is still being interrogated right now. We don't know their identifications yet. We don't have their names. But we know that they are Jewish. We know that they're young men. In fact, some of them are even below the age of 18. They've been identified as minors, and they come from the Jerusalem area.
We don't know anything about their affiliations or what might be behind this, but 24 hours ago, they weren't even sure whether or not it was nationalistic in its nature.
Exactly. That's why this is such a significant breakthrough, because it points us in the direction that Palestinians certainly have suspected, and a lot of Israelis had feared that it was nationalistic. Initially, police had been looking into possible criminal motives or personal motives, but now they've identified the direction from which it came.
Joe, I read a description of the Palestinian mother of the Palestinian boy who was killed, of her reaction, saying that regardless of who was arrested, she didn't trust what was going to happen. And she said, you know, maybe they should treat whoever's arrested their families like they treat our families, burn their houses. It was an angry response. To what extent do you think this arrest will matter to the Palestinian community?
I think what the mother expressed is a common sentiment. There is a lot of distrust toward the Israeli authorities. Relations are bad, and they've been bad for a long time. That said, the situation on the ground seems to be calming today. You see a lot of efforts by the Israeli prime minister, who went on national TV just in the past few minutes to urge calm. Israel's president, Shimon Peres, a Nobel Peace Prize winner, also urging calm. And there are attempts by Israeli officials to work with Arab leaders in northern Israel, where there have been violent protests in the past few days, also working together to get things back to normal. In addition, in East Jerusalem, in the neighborhoods that saw the heaviest rioting, things are moving back to normal today. We see marketplaces reopening. We see the streets are reopening to traffic and people going back to their routines. So the signs are that things are beginning to calm down.
What about the investigation into the murder of the three Israeli teens? Where does that stand?
That continues, and I know it's a high priority for the Israelis. Today we were told that there's been another arrest. It's possibly a significant arrest because it took place in the same town in Hebron, the city of the West Bank, where the suspected killers, who are still on the loose, where they come from. So there's some speculation that today's arrest was significant. That said, Israel has arrested probably about 400 people so far in its ongoing investigation, so no immediate signs of a breakthrough.
I understand there may be developments in another incident, the beating by Israeli police of an American teenager, the cousin of the Palestinian teen who was killed. Any news on that?
Absolutely. He also in the same neighborhood from his cousin who was killed. He was beaten very bad by Israeli security troops during one of the demonstrations the other day. He was released from Israeli custody today. He was in pretty bad shape, two black eyes, his mouth, his face is all swollen, but he's been released to house arrest. He's been ordered to stay with his family while this investigation continues. We spoke to him very briefly, and he just said he's happy to be home.
Josef Federman of the Associated Press from Jerusalem, once again, we thank you.
Thank you.